Welcome to this new how-to. In this how-to, we will look at how you can manually manipulate the flight plan files. This is sometimes needed because the built-in flight plan tool from Flight Simulator 2020 does not create the flight plan you may want to use. Before modifying it, we first need to create a flight plan by selecting the world map. By default, if you just installed Flight Simulator or are using default options, not all the necessary beacons and waypoints are displayed. To display those items, select the open filters on the bottom, scroll to the bottom, and enable at least the NavAids and the Fix and AirNav position report. If you also want to see the airspaces, enable the airspaces. You can see a lot of items are being added to the map. If you don't like it or if you don't need them anymore, you can always revert back to the default by pressing the F12 key or by pressing this button. For now, we will leave them enabled and hit backspace close. Our plan is to visit all the, I would say, large waterworks in the Netherlands, at least in the southern part of the Netherlands. So our departure will be from Rotterdam Airport. So let's select it. Runway 24. Fine for me. If you want, you can also select one of the parkings if you want to prepare first before taking off. But for now, we will leave runway 24 selected. Our destination airport will also be Rotterdam because we're gonna fly a circle. So we're gonna fly via the west coast and to the south, then to the east coast, and then back to Rotterdam Airport. We're also gonna land on runway 24. And as you can see, it already has added both the waypoints here. So let's zoom in a bit, because now we need to add some additional waypoints because we want to visit some of the water works. As you can see, it already selected Rotterdam Airport, so let's add an additional one. And you can simply do that by clicking on an item and selecting add. What will happen then is that the flight plan tool will add the navigation point or the waypoint to the map. So let's add another one. And then we need to go a little bit to the south, because as you can see, here's the river, and in this river there are a few waterworks which we want to look at. So the first one we're gonna add is this one. That's the next beacon. Then we're gonna follow the river and we're gonna fly up till into the North Sea. Simply select that again. Add Oddfil. And then we're going to the part of Zeeland, as we call it in the Netherlands. So we select HSD, followed by the airport Halmstede Airfield. Then here's a large waterwork, so which we also want to have a look at. So let's add this waypoint also, Midden-Zeeland. That's also an airport, very small one. And then we want to go a little bit, I would say, into the countryside. So we add Thole. We add WDT. We add Woody. Putty, and then we fly back, because here's a waterwork, but here in this part also, and we also want to see it. So let's add it. And until now, you can see that, well, everything looks kind of okay-ish. Not completely, because you can see that already it has done something different here. So let's remove Alina, and you will see it returns to this view, because what we want to do is we want to fly via Putty back to Alina and then go a little bit north. But what happens if you add Alina? It will change the way we're flying from Midden-Zeeland to back to Rotterdam. So it makes a weird twist in this traffic pattern. let's ignore it for now and let's see, okay, what do we want to add further to our map? Well, what do we want to add is we want to add the STD one. Then we want to visit this one, which is a very small airport. It's called Vliegveld Nieuwansdorp. Until now it goes kind of okay-ish, but not 100%. So let me look at the other one I want to add. Yeah, Varas, that's the other one. Then I will add Echo Hotel 154. Then I will add the NDB Bacon Rotterdam. Then we will fly, let's select this one first, EH9194. And then also add this one. And add Ross, just to be sure. And as you can see, it makes a big mess of it, because it all flies all kind of weird routes which you don't want, and it doesn't look like a nice circle. So what you can do is, to make it easier for yourself, is modify the flight plan so we can really fly the circle we want to fly. So to do that, what we need to do is we need to save the flight plan first. So once the prompt is there, we click on save and then change the save as type to flight plan. Click the file name or provide a new file name and then hit save. In this case, it already existed, so I'm going to override it. And now the next step is that we're going to modify the flight plan. But before that, we're going to hit reset. So we're going to reset the flight plan here, so nothing's visible here. And then we're going to switch to my favorite text editor, Notepad++. But if you want to use another text editor, feel free to do so. And we're going to open the file. So it's not here. The default location of the file is in your app data directory, in the packages flight simulator directory, and in the local state directory. I will open it. And here's the flight plan, and the flight plan is an XML based file which contains a lot of information. First of all, the title, then the type of flight, in this case VFR, the cruising altitude, the departure ID, then the long and latitudes, the destination ID, again the long and latitudes, the description name and destination name. The application version, not sure where that's used for. Probably it's an internal version number of the tool. And then we see we've got the ATC waypoints. And every waypoint we have added to our map is added as an ATC waypoint item. So what can you change? Well, you can change a lot, right? So in this case, we want to change the cruising altitude and making it a little bit less, because we want to fly it 2,000 feet. Departure ID is fine. Title, well, we can try to change it. Not sure what will happen here, but I will. We'll call Delta Werke, because that's the name of the famous water buildings, or what pieces to which are built to protect the Netherlands from the water. And then the next step is that we're gonna modify the order of the waypoints. So how are we gonna do that? Well, it's kind of easy how you can do that. So what we need to do is we first need to identify where it went wrong. And as you can see here, if we scroll down to the bottom, you can see that after Haamstede Airport, it went directly back to Rotterdam Airport. But that that was not our intention, right? So we need to add, in this case, this complete entry. It always starts with HC waypoint and it ends with a backslash HC waypoint. And as you can see, Notepad++ really marks it, so you're sure that you're selecting the correct part. So let's remove it from here. Scroll to the bottom and paste it here. So that's one fix. Now the other fix we need to perform is we need to modify our move Tola, but also the WDT, the Woody and the Putty one. So let's do I'd like this. Add them here. So now it will be a little bit of, let's say, a big puzzle because we didn't make a screenshot of which waypoint we want to visit. So let's move STD also a little bit to the bottom. Let me think which one was after that one. I think it was. Neumannsdorp and Laras was, they were both somewhere on the end. So I will paste them before EHRD, which is the Rotterdam The Hague Airport. Then let's look at Alina. Alina also needs to be moved. And as you can see, it's not that easy, but it's doable to do it. One thing you can do is make screenshots of the flight plan as you create it, using the tool. Then save the flight plan and then go back to this to your text editor and modify the flight plan. I think it needs to be in here. So Alina, were there other modifications which we need to make? Yes, because here it's also a little bit of a mess. So this one was just before we hit the ground in Rotterdam Airport. Then we've got a few other ones. 191, 184. I'm doing it wrong because Ross was the last waypoint before we hit the ground. Scroll back to the top because I think there was this one. So you need to make sure that there are no white spaces in the file because else it might not work anymore. So make sure that it still is a valid XML file. Rotterdam. We also need to move it. And we need to move Rotterdam. Here. So once you're done with modifying all the stuff, hit save, go back to Flight Simulator and then select the option load save. will prompt you and say, okay, I want to load the file. And here we can see the file which we just modified. So we're selecting open. And let's see what it made of it. Probably we need to make some modifications because we might have forgotten something. So let's have a look. So it will go from Rotterdam EH165, it's fine. I think we forgot something here. EH154. Yeah, this one also needs to be moved because we're gonna fly from here, from Vliegveld Numansdorp to Laras E165. Is the correct way. So you can see there's still some errors, so we need to modify the file again. So what we need to do is we need to modify the E154 entry. So let's hit reset again. Go to or text editor 2 and let's find E154. It's here. And E194 needs to be before the Rotterdam waypoint. It's here. So one thing I forgot to explain is that you can also see the AC waypoint, right? So in this case, STD is an NDB waypoint, while Alina is an intersection. I think also have some VOR channels like WTDT. So you can see we're using multiple types of waypoints during our flight. So let's hit load again. This looks better, right? So this is what it is. So we're flying from Rotterdam, then we're flying to the river, then to the North Sea, to Zeeland, Hamstead Airfield, Midden-Zeeland Airport. Then we're making a circle here because there are multiple waterworks here. Then we're flying to the STD NDP, then to Vliegveld Numansdorp, to Laras, and then back to Rotterdam Airport. So this is it. If you want to start flying, press the fly now button, of course. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button. If you like to see more of these kind of videos, then consider to subscribe, because then you're being updated about new videos being posted. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.